Hello, my name is Oliver Anena, and I am a former immigration equality client. However, today I come to you as a US citizen, as a new American. I'm also serving on the board of immigration equality.
Welcome to the 2021 Safe Haven Awards. For 15 years, immigration equality has held these awards as a way to honor our remarkable pro bono attorney partners. During this time, we have won asylum for over 1,500 individuals, including me. This simply wouldn't be possible without our law firm partners. Tonight, we celebrate those attorneys, our supporters, and the strength of our clients. I am Dr. Ilon Rincon Portas, and I started my relationship with immigration equality 11 years ago as a client seeking help.
It has always been an honor to give back to my community. Back when I was in Nigeria, I did a lot of work to support and create safe spaces for queer people like me. And now to be able to continue to support other queer immigrants like myself through the life-changing work that Immigration Equality and its partner does every day here in the US. This is the reason why we celebrate Safe Haven.
I fled from the horrors waiting for me in Venezuela, and it was lawyers like yourself who helped me get asylum and later on citizenship in 2018. After this year, I can't help but reflect on the privileges I have gained thanks to you. This year particularly, I got to witness incredible stories of courage and resilience from our immigrant communities. When COVID struck, I was part of a group of immigrants who banded together to set up some of the first testing and later some of the first vaccination sites in New York City. This is why I feel more determined than ever that we need to support this work, because it doesn't only save lives, it also brings talent, new ideas, and diversity of experiences that make this country better.
You know, this last year has seen so many changes to the world as a whole. And as we look forward, immigration equality is committed to restoring rights for LGBTQ and HIV positive asylum seekers, while rising to the challenges created by the previous administration.
We have a moral obligation to help those who need it. If someone is fleeing persecution, it is America's obligation to help them. Our goals at Immigration Equality are to ensure that the United States is always a place where queer identified people can come if they need help.
25 years ago, when I was back there in Egypt, we were watching this show that had a trans man in there. The comments that I heard about this man that day, oh my God, they terrified me. They don't know that in my head, God, this is how I feel. So I started to plan to just flee to the United States.
25 years ago, Immigration Equality was a group of volunteer attorneys who spent their spare nights and weekends doing free work for queer immigrants.
The core principles of the organization were the right to love who you love, the right to live with whom you love, and to thrive in the United States if that's what you wanted. We had a few lawyers there. And we also had couples who were desperate to know what they could do. You know, there's power in numbers, and I think that's the sense that they got, that it was going to grow from there.
Today, we are a staff of 19 with pro bono connections of hundreds of attorneys. All of that came from humble beginnings, but the determination has never ended.
When I went to the immigration equality office, I felt safe immediately. Everybody meets you with this smile and happiness, and they make you feel like you're home. They explained the whole process. When do I apply for my green card? And they will be there for me. When do I apply for my citizenship? And they will definitely be there for me. And they were. They never broke a promise. Citizenship meant you belong and you are 100% safe. untouchable.
You should support immigration equality because we have the skill set, the drive, and the passion to make change happen, no matter who's in the White House and no matter who's in Congress.
I thank you from the depth of my heart.
Hi, everyone. Good evening. Thank you so much for joining us tonight for the Safe Haven Awards. My name is Bridget Crawford, and I'm the Legal Director of Immigration Equality. It is my great privilege to honor our pro bono partners this evening. You have donated thousands of hours over the past year, which has enabled Immigration Equality to serve over 800 clients. You have worked tirelessly in the midst of a pandemic and during an unprecedented time when immigration law has changed seemingly on a daily basis to deliver impeccable services to the brave and resilient queer, trans, and HIV positive immigrants that we serve. Through all of this, you have won your cases a remarkable 99% of the time. You have not only provided impeccable legal counsel, but you have done so with compassion and with kindness. Quite literally, your work has saved lives. We are grateful for all of our pro bono partners for this remarkable work. But it is the Safe Haven Awards, and so someone has to win. This year, like all years, was incredibly difficult given the remarkable work. But our first 2021 Safe Haven Award recipient is, no drum roll necessary since you all know the winners already, Catton. Attorneys at Catton do not shy away from taking on complex or challenging immigration cases, be it addressing complex procedural issues, clients with prior removal orders, or clients who have had negative interactions with law enforcement. Catton attorneys are tenacious advocates who do not give up. By way of example, Catton took on the case of a transgender woman from Jamaica who suffered horrific persecution at the hands of the Jamaican police and community members. She came to the United States and was placed in removal proceedings in Florida. She then moved to New York and changed venue, but the New York court had not registered her case. So with her 1 year filing deadline looming, she was desperate to file her application, but had no place to file it. Catton took on her case, and an attorney at Catton went to the New York Immigration Court and demanded that the court open a file for her. He refused to leave until he was allowed to physically file the asylum application with the immigration court. And Catton attorneys are just as able to deftly handle nuanced and complicated aspects of the law. We saw this in an excellent amicus brief drafted by Catton for the Board of Immigration Appeals regarding the process of transitioning. Congratulations to Catton for being this year's Safe Haven Rising Star, and thank you to the Catton team for your tenacious advocacy.
Hello everyone, my name is Amitesh Parekh. I'm a senior staff attorney here at Immigration Equality. Now, as many of you know, over the last 4 years, the US government has made it increasingly difficult for asylum seekers to receive work permits in the United States. Asylum seekers who flee persecution in their countries of origin need work permits in order to be able to support themselves here in the United States. And this is especially true for LGBTQ and HIV positive asylum seekers who may not have access to any kind of social support networks in the United States. Now, additionally, the work permit document can be the only form of ID that an asylum seeker has in the United States. And especially for transgender asylum seekers, the work permit document might be the only form of identity that the person has that reflects their true gender identity. In addition to that, currently USCIS only recognizes male and female as gender markers on the EAD card. There is no option for people to reflect their true gender identity if they are either gender non-binary, agender, or of any other gender. And this is extremely traumatizing for people, especially LGBTQ and HIV positive asylum seekers, who might have suffered persecution in their countries of origin based on their gender identities. Now, Immigration Equality is currently working in collaboration with our sister organizations to change the rules regarding work permits. USCIS must not require either medical or legal proof of someone's gender identity. USCIS should just require a client to self-attest their gender identity. Requiring medical proof or a court order is extremely burdensome for LGBTQ or and or HIV-positive asylum seekers, especially if they don't have authorization to work here in the United States. Now, in addition to that, Immigration Equality is also strongly advocating for the inclusion of an X-gender marker on work authorization documents. And this will help asylum seekers who do not fit neatly within either male or female, or who identify as other genders, to truly and accurately represent their gender identity.
Walking in my sleep at night, making myself crazy. Out of my mind, out of my mind. Wrote it down and read it out, hoping it would save.
At the 2015 annual Safe Haven Awards celebration, I stood at the podium and proudly proclaimed that I had gotten my green card and how great it felt to be able to breathe freely. Today, at yet another Safe Haven Awards celebration in totally different settings, but with the same goal, I am beyond proud to declare that as of April 9th, 2021, I became a naturalized citizen of these great United States of America. My journey to becoming a citizen has not been an easy one. I was once a shy, timid, suspicious, fearful woman. I went from hiding in the shadows to having suicidal intent to learning to trust and believe in a system that has taken a long time. But I am finally here, and today I can exhale. This evening's proceeding is just not about me. It's about a collective effort on the part of an organization that was founded in 1994 that sought to help undocumented HIV and LGBTQ individuals who, like myself, have lived in fear of being deported. I have lived that fear. As a transgendered woman from the Caribbean, I know what it feels like to be ostracized from family. I bore the brunt of mental and physical pain at the hands of individuals who did not understand or refused to accept me. When I entered the doors of Immigration Equality almost 11 years ago, never in my wildest dream did I think that I will be here, in my own space, on my own terms, living my own truth as a citizen of these United States. And to borrow a phrase from Lee Greenwood's song, I am proud to be an American. Today, I am proud to stand with all of you in recognizing the work of all the great people who have helped make the dreams of all of us a possibility and a reality. Thank you for allowing us to dare to dream and to live our own truths. Thank you for all of the hard work and the determination that all of you are instrumental in giving individuals like myself a fighting chance. Today, as I sit in my office, I am happy, I am free, and I feel belonged. As I conclude, I have shared my journey, but I'm just me. There are many other LGBTQ and HIV positive individuals who are suffering in silence, who are in detention centers, and who are losing hope. Let us work toward making their hopes and aspirations a reality. And one day, when my story is complete, you will learn that a young, simple trans woman from a country who rejected her because she dared to be different, owed it all to a country that opened its doors and allowed her to live her own true authentic self. Thank you and have a great evening.
Our next recipient is Cravath, Swain, and Moore. For years, Cravath has been a trusted partner. Cravath attorneys have demonstrated remarkable dedication to every case they take on, devoting firm resources to ensure that clients are given the best possible counsel and are always treated with dignity and respect. 2020 was no exception. For example, the firm zealously advocated for a transgender woman from Central America who was detained in California, subjected to harassment, and denied critical medical treatment for weeks. The firm also compassionately advocated for a client who battled terminal illness throughout his asylum process and tragically passed away during representation. Most recently, the firm represented a Cuban client paroled out of detention. The Cravath attorney went above and beyond to repeatedly meet with the client during a pandemic, including traveling to Florida, briefing complex legal issues, and ultimately arguing a full trial in person at the height of the pandemic. Counsel's relentless advocacy paid off, and the judge granted their client asylum. Congratulations and thank you to the Cravath attorneys for your commitment to queer, trans, and HIV-positive immigrants.
Tonight is a night of celebration and of joining with our friends and partners to recognize the accomplishments that have been achieved with your support and collaboration. And while we want to revel in our successes, and yes, such excitement is justified, especially recognizing the difficult times that these have been, I must bring your attention back, even if only for a moment this evening, to the work still left to do. There are obstacles to justice. And it's important that we continue to advocate for our clients who face arduous situations and journeys in their search for safety. We must push this administration, as we would any other, to improve the ability of our government to protect LGBTQ asylum seekers and those living with HIV. As we speak, what are known as Title 42 expulsions are continuing to be executed at increasing rates. Title 42 comes from a 1944 statute intended to protect public health, but has been used beginning in 2020, with COVID-19 being cited as the justification, despite there being millions of people who travel between the U.S.-Mexico border daily. It gives the Department of Homeland Security the ability to expulse individuals to the country that they last transited through without discretion given to their asylum claims. Not surprisingly, it has overwhelmingly affected those seeking refuge. This policy endangers LGBTQ asylum seekers and those living with HIV as they're prohibited from pursuing the safety that they require. We must also push to resolve the issue of the backlog. As many of you are aware, there are hundreds of thousands of applications pending with no resolution in sight. These pending applications are what are known as the backlog, and through the closures that came following COVID-19, this problem has been exacerbated. Now, many whose cases had already been in the backlog previous to the pandemic will wait in limbo even longer, and the hope that their case might be heard dwindles more with every passing day. To combat these policies, Immigration Equality has teamed up with various sister organizations and pro bono partners. Title 42 is illegal, and we cannot let this policy stand. We are pushing the administration to stop the unlawful expulsion of asylum seekers under the pretext of public health, and your support is what permits us to do so. And with the backlog, every time you, our pro bono partners, file a shortlist request or a mandamus action, you are forcing the government to hear our clients' claims, and you are saving lives. So while there is still much that can and needs to be done, let's take a moment tonight to celebrate our achievements. But we mustn't lose sight of the future we're building.
Hi, my name is Lauren Patton. I'm part of the Broadway company of Jagged Little Pill, and I'm so grateful to be here with y'all tonight. Thank you so much for having me. And thank you so much to Immigration Equality and all of the incredible pro bono attorneys who work with this organization. I've been amazed to find out about your work and what you provide for queer folks all over the world who are seeking asylum and seeking a safe place to live and to be free. So very grateful to be part of this. Thank you for your work. And I'm gonna sing you a song from Jagged Little Pill, one of my favorite things that I get to sing in it, and something that never fails to put a smile on my face, so hopefully it'll do the same for you. This is Hand in My Pocket. I'm broke, but I'm happy. I'm poor, but I'm kind. I'm short, but I'm healthy, yeah! I'm high, but I'm grounded. I'm sane, but I'm overwhelmed. I'm lost, but I'm hopeful, baby. What it all comes down to is that everything's gonna be fine, fine, fine. 'Cause I got one hand in my pocket and the other one is giving a high five. I feel drunk, but I'm sober. I'm young and misunderstood. I'm tired, but I'm working, yeah! I care, but I'm restless. I'm here, but I'm really gone. I'm right, and I'm sorry, baby. What it all comes down to is that everything's gonna be quite alright. 'Cause I got one hand in my pocket and the other one is flicking a cigarette. What it all comes down to is that I haven't got it all figured out just yet. But I got one hand in my pocket and the other one is giving a peace sign. I'm free, but I'm focused. I'm green, but I'm wise. I'm hard, but I'm friendly, baby. I'm sad, but I'm laughing. I'm brave, but I'm chicken shit. I'm sick, but I'm pretty, baby. What it all boils down to is that no one's really got it figured out just yet. Hey. But I got one hand in my pocket and the other one is playing the piano. And what it all comes down to, my friends, yeah, is that everything is just fine, fine, fine. 'Cause I got one hand in my pocket and the other one is hailing a taxi cab.
Our next safe haven recipient is Aiken Gump. Over the years, attorneys at Aiken Gump have not only been game to take on a lot of cases, they've been game to take on very difficult cases. And in each and every instance, they go above and beyond. For example, this past year, Aiken attorneys volunteered to work with a detained client in a remote facility in Texas. Despite having virtually no advance notice, immediately upon taking the case, they rushed to the facility to accompany the client to his master calendar hearing in front of a very difficult immigration judge. The client was struggling in immigration detention and desperate to get out. The Aiken Gump team quickly prepared and filed a parole request with ICE in a facility where parole is not routinely granted, and secured release almost immediately. And they made sure that the client quickly got to a safe place to live. This is the type of dedication the Akin Gump team provides to all of their clients. In addition, the Akin Gump team is always willing to jump in to assist with any project. Be it research or filing an amicus brief, the Akin Gump team is always responsive and willing to support Immigration Equality's mission. Congratulations and thank you to all of the Akin Gump attorneys for your remarkable work and your dedication to your clients.
In immigration detention, there are opportunities for progress, but a lot of things that have to change. One big thing that needs to change is that LGBTQ and HIV positive asylum seekers are still being detained. I recently spoke with a transgender man being held at a detention center where somebody recently tested positive for COVID-19. Obviously, that is unacceptable. Asylum seekers should not be placed in dangerous environments. One opportunity for progress is that the DHS is willing to listen to our concerns and address some of the problems that we are seeing. We have been advocating with the DHS to release all HIV positive and transgender people from immigration detention. We will continue to talk to the DHS and put pressure on them to let out all LGBTQ and HIV positive asylum seekers from custody.
Hello to my friends in Immigration Equality and this wonderful community of advocates and supporters. I'm Brian King, President of the Caribbean and Latin America region for Merit International and a very proud member of the Board of Immigration Equality. Like everyone, I wish we could be celebrating in person, and I hope this is the last time I need to speak to all of you through my computer. To say this past year is difficult would be an understatement. Well, the pandemic has impacted every aspect of life, but when tragedy strikes, it hits marginalized communities the hardest, allowing neglect to continue and scapegoating to rise. Members of our community have been disproportionately impacted economically, with nearly two-thirds of LGBTQ households having lost a job since the pandemic began. LGBTQ households lost health insurance at double the rate of their non-LGBTQ counterparts. LGBTQ individuals reported a higher rate of mental health issues and even higher for LGBTQ people of color. Why? Is a question we must always ask ourselves. But I fear the answer is that we live in an unfair and unequal world. From acts of hate against Asian Americans and Pacific Islanders to anti-trans youth healthcare laws that ban gender-affirming treatments to making it illegal to hand someone a bottle of water while they're in line to vote. We're reminded every day of how much work there is yet to be done to create a world of equality for all. That is why I am so thankful for IE. They don't look at the issues and at the world and just shy away. They rise up and they fight, and they're determined to do what they can do to help one person at a time. At Marriott, we continue to push for policy like the Equality Act that works to uphold the rights and ensure vital protections. We continue to foster a culture of diversity, equality, and inclusion, building on areas where we're strong and being completely transparent when we're not. And we'll continue to support organizations like Immigration Equality that are dedicated to making our world a better place, as it should be. Thank you to Immigration Equality and every one of their supporters. Have a fantastic evening.
My name is Laverne Cox, and I support LGBTQ plus immigrants, and I support immigration equality. I think it's crucial to support LGBTQ plus immigrants fleeing persecution, because that is what the United States of America should be all about. We're the nation that says, give me your tired, your poor, your huddled masses yearning to be free. And in a lot of places in this world, you cannot be free. And so what I love about immigration equality is that they're doing the work to have intersectional conversations about the issues of immigration and where they intersect with LGBTQ plus issues. And that is a conversation I'm all about having. I think our queer and trans immigrants make our country stronger, just like all of our immigrants make our country stronger. The perspectives, the different cultures, the diversity is so exciting. I mean, we're here in New York City right now, and one of the things I love about this city is how diverse it is, how there's just so many different kinds of people, and I have learned so much living in this city for over 20 years of my life about other cultures, and that has enriched my life, and I think that is what it should be all about. For everyone who has fled your country and you're seeking asylum here in the United States of America, thank you for coming to us, and thank you for thinking that we're going to be a place for you, a refuge for you, and I hope that we fulfill that promise to you and that this is going to be a better situation for you than the one that you've left. There are people here who love you and who value and welcome you, and can't wait to see what you do here.
And our final Safe Haven Award recipient is Sullivan and Cromwell. Immigration Equality and Sullivan and Cromwell have been close partners for many years. Throughout those years, Sullivan and Cromwell has taken on a huge number of cases, providing the highest quality of representation in each and every instance. And Sullivan and Cromwell has increased Immigration Equality's capacity by partnering with in-house counsel at Deutsche Bank to assist even more asylum seekers. Sullivan and Cromwell always goes above and beyond for their clients. For instance, they hired local investigators in Guyana to assist a client, and they helped a gay man from Cuba with a novel approach to relief under the Cuban Adjustment Act. During the over 4,000 hours donated in 2020, Sullivan and Cromwell not only represented individuals in their asylum applications, the firm also filed a mandamus action in federal court and provided samples and advice in connection with our mandamus project. They also led two of our impact litigation cases, the DeVos Banks case and the Zaghari Blixt case, which challenged the State Department's refusal to recognize the U.S. citizenship of children born abroad to married same-sex couples. In October 2020, a three-judge panel from the Ninth Circuit unanimously upheld a ruling in the DeVos Banks case, recognizing the citizenship from birth of Ethan DeVos Banks. In addition to their exceptional advocacy, Sullivan and Cromwell has a unique ability to personally connect with and empower their clients. During this past summer, their client was boldly featured in a striking photo on the front page of the New York Times, proudly waving a giant rainbow flag above a crowd of nearly 15,000 people during the Black Trans Lives Matter demonstration. Congratulations and thank you, Sullivan and Cromwell, for your work. And thank you to all of our pro bono teams for your commitment to LGBTQ and HIV positive non-citizens.
Today, we remember and honor one of Immigration Equality's strongest supporters, Ray Fisher. Last year, we lost our dear friend Ray after a tragic accident at his home in Pennsylvania. Now, we celebrate him as an ardent believer in human rights who was deeply devoted to Immigration Equality's mission. Ray was a very kind and truly thoughtful person who served on our board for many years, including as the board chair. And even after his board service was complete, Ray stayed remarkably engaged in our work, rejoicing in our victories and encouraging our progress. Ray, we thank you for all you did for immigration equality and for the LGBTQ immigrants we serve. We will miss you very much. To commemorate Ray for his years of service, we are naming our highest honor, our Global Vision Award, after him. This award celebrates a movement leader who has shown an exemplary commitment to support the rights of LGBTQ and HIV-positive immigrants. I am excited to present the Fisher Global Vision Award to Idafe Okporo. Idafe is a gay refugee from Nigeria who was granted asylum through Immigration Equality's pro bono program in 2017. When he lived in Nigeria, a homophobic mob attacked Idafe because of his work advocating for LGBTQ access to healthcare. Shortly thereafter, he fled to the US. And today, Idafe is a global LGBTQ rights activist and the executive director of the RDJ Refugee Shelter in Harlem. The shelter provides housing and social services to help refugees transition to life in America. Idafe is a David Prize 2020 winner, the author of the forthcoming book, Asylum, A Memoir and Manifesto, and the founder of the consulting group, The Pont. Please welcome Idafe Okporo.
Hi, everyone. My name is Idafe Okporo. I'm honored to be awarded the Ray Fisher Global Vision Award by Immigration Equality. It's quite of an irony to be given an award by an organization that is deserving of all this award. I would not be in the United States today if not for the work of Immigration Equality. 4 years ago, when I arrived at the border and I got detained by ICE, I thought all hope was lost and likely to be deported back to my own country, Nigeria. Immigration Equality was my lifeline. They provided a toll-free number from the detention center, which enabled me to reach out and get connected to a pro bono legal representation by David Boyce and Plimpton. After my release from the detention center, I wanted to do something back for the community. I took the opportunity to start a role as the director of a shelter, providing access to safe space for other LGBTQ identified refugees. In the last 4 years, we have been able to support over 2,700 asylum seekers, and yet I'm forever grateful to Immigration Equality for representing me and enabling my voice to flourish as a refugee in America. The main issue with LGBTQ people coming to America to seek protection is that we don't want to leave our country, but we do. But when we do, how do we rejoin a new society? This is a question and the dilemma I've been trying to solve. Refugees who come to America need a form of social services, especially LGBTQ refugee. This is a problem I seek to solve in the United States and globally. Secondly, why there is a globalized fight for human rights on so many fronts like the Me Too movement, the fight against police brutality, when it comes to LGBTQ rights, there is no ripple effect across the globe. I want to change that. I want us all to change that. This award to me is a lot. It confirms my vision for a better world for all LGBTQ people, and it shows an appreciation when I needed it the most. I did not meet Ray in person, and it's an honor to be awarded an award after him. I hope to continue to fight for global rights of LGBTQ people, because none of us are free until all of us are free. Thank you very much.
Love is love. It doesn't matter the gender.
My name is Stefania. This is Lucas Massi.
And I'm Allison. When we met, the US government didn't recognize our relationship. I couldn't sponsor her for a visa.
Allison left the US, I left Italy.
So I moved here in 2008 and have lived in London for almost a decade. When we met, we did talk about having a family, and it was something we would do down the line.
To get pregnant and to have Lucas, it was amazing. I just can't describe the joy from the moment that he was born. He was with us all the time.
I remember so clearly being so tired, but so happy.
With Massey, I was the one watching since it was Alison giving birth. It's amazing and it's a completely different adventure now.
When we went to get Lucas's citizenship, we went to the US Embassy, thought that it was gonna be fine because we were married, he was born in wedlock. We had done all the paperwork, and she said, unless the American partner is the genetic mother, then the child doesn't get citizenship, so Lucas doesn't get citizenship.
There was a lot of crying that day, unfortunately.
The government saying, no, you're not his mother. It makes me feel, again, rejected, all the things I felt from the US. And now it wasn't just directed at me, it was directed at my child.
She really felt like she had been kicked out from her own country.
If Stefania were a man, when we walked into the embassy and said we're the parents, they would never have asked who gave birth.
Who is the mother, who is the biological mother? It doesn't really matter. We are both mothers.
Lucas, to me, is the same as Mossy is to me. They're both my children.
She's everything. She's the one that gets up with him in the morning. She's the one that brings him to school. She's the one that sees him walk for the first time.
I want our children to find happiness in whatever they find happiness in. I don't want my child to feel kicked out and to have to feel rejected by their own country.
And the truth is, there is not such a thing as equality yet. Like, we are not treated the same. We will get there.
Good evening. My name is Aaron Morris, and I am the Executive Director of Immigration Equality. You know, in 2018, when we introduced you to Alison and Stefania, we were just embarking on our litigation campaign, against the State Department for discriminating against our community. But I've got good news. And it is that as of Tuesday, 2 days ago, the State Department has finally capitulated. 4 lawsuits, and many years later, they're done. And they finally agree that Alison and Stefania are married, which seems insane, but that was their contention, and that their children are born U.S. citizens. And I think this is proof positive that the beautiful relationship between immigration equality and pro bono counsel can result in remarkable victories. So thank you to Sullivan & Cromwell, Morgan Lewis, and Lambda Legal for being partners on this. We changed it. We did it. And thank you all for supporting that work. But it also makes me reflect on the timing of justice and that it requires patience and perseverance. Our colleague Stephanie told us this week that we finally could celebrate the victory of 2 gay men from the Republic of Georgia. They were horribly persecuted just because they were in love. And they did everything right when they came to the U.S. They fled here. They found pro bono counsel through Immigration Equality. They got married. They filed on time for asylum. And then they waited for 5 years. For 5 years. And the only reason that their case was heard is because they had remarkable counsel that pushed them forward. Even while we celebrate that victory, we acknowledge the destruction of a system that won't hear a case. And so we commit ourselves to solving that problem. With you, with your support. We'll get there. We always get there. We always find a way. And I feel like a lot of people are asking me, what's different now between the Trump administration and the Biden administration? And the difference is, the only tool in our arsenal under Trump was a lawsuit. And we filed a lot of them. We filed one to protect the asylum system altogether. It's called Immigration Equality versus the Department of Homeland Security. It is a giant attempt that will win to dismantle Trump administration regulations. They're stalled. The Biden administration has agreed to stall them. We mean to see them undone. But it's also access to the White House and to agencies that we should have that we didn't under Trump. And we meet with the administration a lot. And we've given them, which they have asked for, the pathway forward for LGBTQ immigrants and refugees. But the truth is, they will only walk that path if we push them down it. So let this be the year of being pushy. Let us all commit to being as pushy as possible, regardless of the political situation, regardless of the opportunity. Let us push forward equality and safety for queer LGBTQ immigrants. Thank you. Thank you for coming. Thank you for supporting us. Thank you to the board of directors for being such leaders in one of the hardest years this organization has ever seen. Thank you for Pro Bono Council. Congratulations to Adafe and our winners of other Safe Haven Awards. And a most heartfelt thank you to the staff of Immigration Equality. You are remarkable. I am so amazed what we do every day, and I am very proud to be among you. Stick around for a message from Allison and Stefania.
From the first time we were denied at the embassy, we knew that we were going to fight for Lucas and for other families like ours. And we couldn't have fought this battle without Immigration Equality and Sullivan and Cromwell by our side. And for all of our team, we are forever grateful. And for now, we're really happy with the news out of the State Department today, and we'll wait to see what next steps happen. But we can't wait for the day that we can say to Lucas, you are American, and to other families like ours, we can say your children are American. Lucas.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Well, if you haven't yet, please consider donating to Immigration Equality using the link or the QR code on the screen. No donation amount is too small, and each dollar will help Immigration Equality provide free legal services to even more LGBTQ and HIV positive asylum seekers. Please consider donating to help make your services free and affordable for everyone who needs them. So with that, we have come to the end of the celebration.
Thank you so much for joining us, and thank you for everyone who made tonight possible. Our amazing event sponsors, our host committee members, and everyone who spoke or performed during the event.
We thank you all for being here with us and for your generous donations. We wish you a wonderful night. Viva la lucha continua.
Are you excited that you're American?
Yes!